Okay.
Yes. सर स्क्रीन स्क्रीन ऑन हो गया ना.
हाँ ऑन है, बिल्कुल ऑन है.
ओके ओके. So good afternoon everybody. So today I'll be discussing the chapter transport in plants. So in the previous sessions I have discussed 50 questions. So now I'll be coming to question number 73, because in the previous session I have said that remaining questions should be solved by the students. I'll be going to the next subtopic in the chapter, that is topic 3, long distance transport of water. So let me come to question number 73. In an elegant experiment, if a twig bearing white flowers placed in a colored water and had washed it turn color, this experiment very easily demonstrates that. Option number A, the path of water movement is through xylem. Option number B, the path of water movement is through phloem. Option number C, the path of food transport is through phloem. And option number D, both A and C. Okay, so what is this question about, students? We are talking about a shoot which bears white flower, and in that we had placed it in a colored water solution, and we have seen that it has changed the color. So the question asks, what is this movement due to? We all know that it is the mainly xylem, which is the water conducting tissue, which helps in the transportation of water as well as mineral ions. So the color change is mainly due to the activity of xylem. So 100% option number A, the path of water movement is through xylem, is the right option for this question. Option B, if you see carefully, the path of water movement is through phloem. Phloem actually is not the major water conducting tissue. So option B is wrong. The path of food transport is through phloem is 100% statement is right, but this is not our answer because it is not related to the question. Okay, in the question we have to talk about the stained solution or the coloring solution. Phloem does not conduct that. Phloem conducts the food or the organic substances. So option C is not the answer. Option number D, both A and C also are not the answer. So option A, question number 73. Now let us come to question number 74. So question number 74, cytoplasmic streaming mainly or may aid in. So cytoplasmic streaming, what is cytoplasmic streaming? Cytoplasmic streaming is also called as cyclosis, which refers to the movement of cytoplasmic contents within the plasma membrane. In with respect to cytoplasmic streaming, there is movement of organelles, organic substances, metabolites within the cytoplasm. This property is mainly attributed to the eukaryotic cells. It is completely absent in prokaryotic organisms. Okay, so this is helping in what transport or what movement? This is the question asked here. So if we read the options carefully, option number A states symplastic movement. Option number B is apoplastic movement. Option number C, both A and B. And option number D is none of the above. So cytoplasmic streaming is mainly aiding in the process of symplastic movement. That is option number A. What is symplastic movement? If you remember the transport of water across the root zone, that is how it moves from epidermis to the xylem vessels, there are two types of movement, students. One is called as the apoplast and another one is the symplast. Okay, so what is apoplast? Apoplast is nothing but movement through cell wall and intercellular spaces. It is also called as non-living continuum between cells. Okay, and symplast is nothing but movement through the cytoplasm, wherein the contents have to cross the plasma membrane, pass through the cytoplasm. Okay, and definitely cytoplasmic streaming helps in symplastic movement because it helps in the transport of water and ions within the cytoplasm. Option A, symplastic movement, is the answer for question number 74. Let us come to question number 75. So question number 75, what is this? Let us read. Read the following statements and find out the incorrect statement. Okay. You have to find out the wrong statement from this given statements. Let us see the options. Option A, the upper class does not provide any barrier to water movement and water movement is through mass flow. As I said in the previous question, what is upper class, students? Upper class here refers to transfer of water across the cell wall and through intercellular spaces. Okay. It does not cross the plasma membrane, it never enters the protoplasm. So apoplast does not provide any barrier to water movement and water movement is through mass flow. 100% this is the correct statement. So this is not the answer. There is no barrier for apoplast because water is not entering the cytoplasm. Okay. Symplastic movement is relatively slower. Option B, he says that in symplast, movement is slower. 100% statement is right. If you compare apoplast and symplast, definitely symplastic movement is slow. Apoplastic movement is faster. Why it is faster? Because in apoplast, there is no barrier, so process is faster. In symplast, since it is entering the protoplasm, it depends on the metabolic condition of this cell and definitely it is retarded or relatively slower. Statement B is the correct statement, which is not our answer. Let us go to statement C. Cytoplasmic streaming is observed in cells of hydrilla. The movement of chloroplast due to streaming is easily visible. Yes, this statement is also a right statement. What is told in this statement? Streaming is observed in the cells of hydrilla leaf. Yes, hydrilla, which is an aquatic plant. Easily you can notice or note the cytoplasmic streaming. And why this usually happens is with respect to movement of chloroplast due to streaming. Because it depends on the intensity of light. Okay. If more intensity of light is there, then chloroplast will not come to the periphery. If light intensity is low, then chloroplast will be at the peripheral region of the cell. So definitely this statement C is also a right statement. No doubt about that. So what is statement D? Movement of water through the root layers is ultimately apoplastic in the endodermis. This statement is a wrong statement. What is wrongly stated in this statement is movement of water through root layers is ultimately apoplastic in the endodermis. This part is totally wrong because endodermis is innermost layer of the cortex, what we say, and endodermis layer is that layer which is having a deposition of lignin and suberin in it. Definitely this layer will be providing a barrier for the movement. Are you understanding? So it is in endodermis, water absolutely does not pass through the apoplast. So this statement gets totally wrong. In endodermis, water must follow the simple plastic pathway. That is the reason statement D is a incorrect, is an incorrect statement. That's the reason we have to look for, or you have to go for this option, that is option number D. I hope it is clear. Here apoplast is totally wrong in endodermis. Okay. Now let us go to question number 76. Okay. So what is question number 76? Long distance transport of substance within a plant cannot be done by diffusion alone. Diffusion is a slow process. The movement of molecules across a typical plant cell about 50 micrometer takes approximately. Okay. So here, long distance transport. Since we are discussing long distance transport, we should know that diffusion alone is not sufficient or responsible for long distance transport because it is a slow process. It takes time and the water and other movement, other particles have to move for a very long distance. It can be meters of height. Okay. So diffusion is not sufficient. Diffusion is a slow process. Movement of molecule across a typical cell about 50 micrometer. This is 100% your statement from your NCERT textbook. So you should know that a molecule, when it has to pass a typical cell of just 50 micrometer size, it takes nearly how much time? It takes nearly 2.5 seconds. Option C is the right answer, 2.5 seconds. So if you just calculate randomly, if a plant is having 1 meter or 2 meter length, then definitely it will take many days for the water to reach that entire length. So 100% diffusion is not sufficient for the long distance transport. Answer is option C, 2.5 seconds. Okay. Question number 77. Long distance transport of water, minerals and foods is generally carried out by option A, diffusion only, active transport only, bulk flow system or the mass flow system, and last one is cytoplasmic streaming supplemented by active transport. So what is the question about? Again, we are talking about the long distance transport of water, minerals and food, and generally what is the mode of transport is asked in this question. So option number A, if you see, diffusion only is totally wrong, because in the previous question itself I have explained diffusion is not sufficient for long distance transport. Active transport only, again it is wrong. Why it is wrong? Because this only is wrong. Of course active transport occurs, but alone it is not sufficient for the long distance transport. So option B goes wrong. Option C, bulk flow system or the mass flow system, 100% this option C is the right answer. So what is this bulk flow or the mass flow system? Mass flow is nothing but you have studied a hypothesis that is called as Mann's mass flow hypothesis or bulk flow hypothesis, where transport occurs from source to sink, okay, in a bulk manner, and for that many conducting tissues like xylem and phloem both are involved in this. So definitely option C is the answer for 77. Last option also we'll see, cytoplasmic streaming supplemented by active transport. So if you see, cytoplasmic streaming supplemented by active transport is also not correct here, students. Why it is not correct? Because cytoplasmic streaming alone is also not sufficient. So option would be option, answer would be option C, that is bulk flow or the mass flow. Let us go to question number 78. Okay. So what is question number 78? You can see, bulk flow can be achieved through a hydrostatic pressure gradient. So the negative hydrostatic pressure gradient and positive hydrostatic pressure gradient are seen in. Okay. So what is bulk flow is explained in this statement. It is achieved through a hydrostatic pressure gradient, 100%. Okay. So how does this happen? How are you going to understand this, students? Because we know that during phloem transport, there is a pressure gradient due to which the organic substances will undergo wean loading and wean unloading. So wean loading and wean unloading occurs by means of active transport, where the sugar or sucrose will be loaded into the elements of phloem. So definitely there is a gradient existing. So negative hydrostatic pressure gradient and positive hydrostatic pressure gradient, where do you observe this generally? Option number A, suction through a straw and a garden hose respectively. Option number B, garden hose and suction through a straw respectively, cobalt chloride paper and polythene respectively, blotting paper and cobalt chloride paper respectively. So the answer straight away, it's a direct question. Negative hydrostatic pressure is observed in suction through a straw, okay, and a garden hose. Positive hydrostatic pressure is observed in a garden hose. Option number A is the right answer for question number 78. Okay, so what is question number 79? Let us see here. So question number 79 states that the bulk movement of substances through the conducting or vascular tissue of plant is called as. A very simple question, direct statement or definition is asked here. Bulk movement of substance through conducting or vascular tissue of plants is called as. So let us see what are the options here for this question. Let us see the options. The options are, the first option is translocation, second option is transpiration, third option transamination, and the last option is transportation. So bulk flow or mass flow, there is a direct terminology and that is nothing but translocation. Option number one, translocation. So what is translocation? I repeat, it is nothing but the mass flow of substances over a long distance by means of conducting tissue. This is the absolute definition. Transpiration, what is transpiration? It is the loss of water from the aerial parts in the form of what? Vapors. This is not the answer. Transamination. What is C option? Transamination. Transamination is nothing but transfer of amino group from one, can be amino acid or from one substrate to another substrate. That is transfer of NH2 or the amino group. That is transamination. Transportation is a general terminology. We are studying the chapter itself as transport. So what is the answer? Option number A, translocation is the option, that is answer for this question 79. Now, we'll see the question number 80. Mineral salts, some organic nitrogen and hormones are translocated by. Okay, so majorly we are talking about mineral salts, some organic nitrogen, not the major organic nitrogen. Okay, students, some organic nitrogen and hormones are translocated by. So by seeing this mineral salt itself, you should come to the conclusion that it is the water conducting tissue, that is xylem, which is mainly responsible for the conduction of mineral salt. Along with that, it also conducts hormones, and of course some organic nitrogen like some amide and all can be conducted through the xylem tissue. Phloem cannot be the answer because some organic nitrogen, here phloem goes wrong. Phloem is the major tissue which conducts the major organic substances. So phloem is wrong. So again, in this regard, both xylem and phloem would be wrong. Why sieve tube elements are wrong? Because you know that sieve tube elements are nothing but they are the components of the phloem tissue. Okay. So if you just recall, xylem has different components like tracheids, vessels, xylem fibers, xylem parenchyma. Similarly, phloem has phloem fibers, phloem parenchyma, sieve tube, and one more is the companion cells. So that's why option D is not the answer for this question 80. Answer is option number A. Okay. Now, let us come to question number 81. Water is absorbed along with mineral solutes by the root haze. So here in this question, we have to understand about the water absorption by the root system. Okay. So in the previous class itself, I said that root haze. What are these root haze? Root haze are nothing but unicellular structures which mainly help to increase the surface area. And what is the purpose of increasing the surface area? To help in the process of absorption. So water is absorbed along with mineral solutes. What is the processes asked in this question? That means how water is absorbed. Option A, partly by diffusion and partly by active transport. Option B, partly by facilitated diffusion and partly by active transport. Option C, purely by diffusion. And option D is purely by active transport. So what is the right answer for this question, students? Option number one, if you see, partly by diffusion and partly by active transport is totally wrong, because water does not absolutely enter by means of active transport. This part is absolutely wrong. This may be right. Partly by diffusion may be right, but this part is totally wrong. Let us see the option B, partly by facilitated diffusion and partly by active transport. Again, this part is totally wrong, and this facilitated diffusion is also not appropriate. So what is the answer? Purely by diffusion. Option number C, purely by diffusion, should be the right answer here. That is, a option C is the right answer. What is option D telling us? Purely by active transport, absolutely wrong. It is mainly diffusion which helps in the absorption of water. So why diffusion occurs, students? Because you should know that it mainly depends on the water potential of this root hair cells. Okay, root hair cells have low water potential, soil has high water potential, so water will be diffusing from soil region into the root hair cells. That is the main reason. So how do you answer this question with respect to water potential? Once again, I am repeating, root hair cells have what low water potential, so soil has high. The water has a tendency always, you know that, it moves from high water potential to low water potential, and hence diffusion is absolutely responsible. So 81, answer is C. Let us see question number 82. Once water is absorbed by the root hairs, it can move deeper into the root layers by two distinct pathways. Okay, very simple question, direct question. Okay, so if you want, you can just look at the diagram below here. Okay, I have just zoomed it. You can just refer to the diagram. Once water is absorbed by the root hair, here will be the root hair where I am just highlighting. Okay, and once it is absorbed, it moves into the inner layers by different pathways. Two different pathways are there. What are those? One in xylem and second in phloem. One in active and second is passive. One is apoplast and second is symplast. And last one is tracheid and second is vessel. So just to see how does it move, it is asked here. One in xylem and second in phloem, totally wrong. Because we are talking about water. We are not talking about food in this question. So we need not refer or we need not include phloem. Option A is a wrong option because phloem is included. And one in xylem, you cannot say because xylem is present in the vascular bundles. Okay. So here, deeper layers, if water is moving from the periphery to the deeper layer, xylem is completely absent in the peripheral layer, student. So xylem and phloem both are wrong here. Okay, I hope you are following. One is active and second is passive. Okay, so here also one is active and second is passive is totally wrong here. So what is happening here, how water is moving is, water is moving by diffusion, students. And there are two pathways, as I have told many times in the previous question. One pathway is called apoplast and other pathway is called as symplast. Okay, so now what is apo and symplast also I've said in the previous question. Apoplast, how does water move? Water moves through the cell wall and intercellular spaces. It absolutely does not enter the cytoplasm or the protoplasm of the cell. It is a non-living continuum between cells. Okay. Then what is symplast? Symplast, water moves between the adjacent cells passing through the cytoplasm. And what is the mode? It is mainly moving through plasmodesmata. You can refer into the diagram here and labeling is given plasmodesmata very clearly. What is this plasmodesmata? These are the interconnections between two adjacent cells. Okay. And this plasmodesmata is also called cytoplasmic streaming between two cells, continuity between two cells, where the particles can be shared between two adjacent cells. This is plasmodesmata. Okay. So in symplast, water definitely takes the help of plasmodesmata. So option C, one is apo and other is symplast, is absolutely the right answer for this question 82. Last option is wrong, tracheid and second is vessel. So what are these tracheid and vessel? If you just recall, these are the elements of xylem tissue. So they are not present here. As I said, xylem is not here in this region. Xylem is actually here. Later, tracheids and vessel come into picture. But now they do not have any role, absolutely. So answer, what answer you should go for? Option number C, 82, option number C. Okay. Now, let us go to the question 83. So in question 83, it's a similar question only. If you just see, it's a similar question. You have to just find out the proper labelings here. Recognize the figure and find out the correct matching here. So what is the correct matching? You see A, B, C, D is asked here. So now, first of all, let us see what is this A. This A is nothing but epidermis. Okay, I repeat, it is the outermost layer of the root region and this is the epidermal layer, okay, which are parenchymatous in nature. Then what is B? B is nothing but, what is B second? If you see, B is nothing but after epidermis, what is the next region, student? This is the cortex region or the cortical layer, we say. Cortical layer, one or two layers thick. Again, non-chlorenchymatous cells or parenchymatous cells are present here. This is cortex. Then what is C here? If you see, this C region is nothing but it is the endodermal region or the endodermis. So what is endodermis? I repeat, endodermis is also referred to as the inner layer of the cortex region. So this is the endodermis layer. And one more thing here in the diagram, a labeling is given, Casparian strip. So what is this Casparian strip? Casparian strip is nothing but a layer which shows deposition of lignin and suberin, which is impermeable to water as well as other substances. And the name Casparian is given because of the name of scientist Caspary, and it is an impermeable layer. You should know that this is an impermeable, it blocks the passage of water. So this is endodermis with Casparian strip. D is what? D is the pericycle, okay, innermost layer which is in contact or close proximity to the vascular bundle. So here xylem is labeled. This xylem and next phloem will be present. These are the vascular bundles. Okay. So now you have to understand the labelings here. What did I say? Epidermis, cortex, endodermis, pericycle. So with that, A is epidermis, then B is cortex, then C is endodermis, and D is pericycle. Option A is the right answer. I repeat, question number 83, option A is the right answer. Okay. Now, we'll go to question number 84. So, let us see what is question number 84. Apoplasm is a system of adjacent cell walls that is continuous throughout the plant except at the. Okay, similar question. We have seen the diagram also. So, what is this question? It is adjacent cell wall arrangement 100% continuous throughout the plant except there is one region where apoplast does not occur. Students, there is one region where apoplast is absent. What is that region? Once again, I'm going back to the diagram. What is that region? If you see, it is the endodermal region where apoplast does not occur. That means the water cannot move through the cell wall. Why the water cannot move through the cell wall and intercellular spaces? Because of lignin and suberin deposition. It is impermeable, I already said. Okay. So, endodermis, this region is the only region where water is blocked, in other words. So, what is this question? Apoplast is a system through which there is a continuous movement through the plant except the number one plasmodesmata, number two vessel elements, number three, number C, Casparian strips of endodermis, and D is tracheids. So if you see direct answer for this question would be what? Option C, Casparian strips of endodermis. Okay, 100% plasmodesmata is not the answer. Why it is not the answer? Plasmodesmata is not a part of apoplast. It is never a part of apoplast. It is a part of symplast. Vessel elements nowhere related because I said they are present in the inner, in the vascular bundles. Tracheids also nowhere related. So the answer straight away is option C, Casparian strips of endodermis. Okay. Now, let us go to question number 85. Okay, so what is 85? Which pathway involves cell wall and intercellular space? Again, a direct question here. Which pathway involves cell wall and intercellular spaces? So directly we should come to option D, apoplastic pathway. Okay, so symplast would be wrong. Vascular pathway, it is through the tissue. Protoplast pathway. Protoplast, what is protoplast? Let me tell you. Protoplast is a plant cell from which cell wall has been removed. Okay, that is called as protoplast. Okay, so option D is the right answer for question number 85. Okay, now we'll see question number 86. What is 86? Force of cohesion develops due to. Okay, so what is cohesion? If you have attended last session, I have said that cohesion. What is cohesion? If you just recall transpiration, students, in transpiration, the theory is given. When theory is given, we'll as well come about that part in the next main session. Transpiration questions I'll be discussing anyways, don't bother. But let me tell you here what is cohesion. Cohesion is related to transpiration. So transpiration, a loss of water, you know, there's a theory which explains transpiration, and the theory is called as cohesion adhesion surface tension theory. I repeat, cohesion adhesion surface tension theory. So let me tell you what is cohesion. Cohesion is nothing but mutual attraction among the water molecules due to the formation of hydrogen bonds. I repeat, cohesion refers to mutual attraction of water molecules due to formation of hydrogen bonds. That means water molecules are attracted or bonded to each other by hydrogen bond. This phenomenon is called as cohesion. So question is, force of cohesion develops due to what? Attraction between similar molecules, attraction between different molecules, and let us go to the other two options, surface tension at the interface, all of the above. So what do you think? I have already given the definition of cohesion just now. It is attraction between water molecules. I said it can be any similar molecule. So straight away, option A would be the right answer. This property, that means when similar molecules are attracted to each other itself, is called as cohesion. Okay, so option A for 86, option A is the right answer. Then, let us see question number 87. Okay, so what is 87? Path of water movement from soil to xylem is. Path of water movement from soil to xylem is. So, metaxylem, then protoxylem, then cortex, then soil, and then root hair. Cortex, root hair, endodermis, pericycle, protoxylem and metaxylem. From soil, then to root hair, then to cortex, then to endodermis, then to pericycle, then proto and then metaxylem. From pericycle to soil, then root hair, cortex, etc., etc. Okay. So now, very simple question. You have to just find out the pathway of water movement. To understand this, the same diagram will be applicable here. So here will be the root hair. If you just see the diagram, from root hair, where the water enters into, or from soil directly if you start, where the water enters into, from soil, the water enters into the root hair. Okay, it enters into the root hair. The next layer will be, actually epidermis is not mentioned in this like options. Okay, epidermis is not mentioned, need not worry. Okay, you have to just follow the sequence here, that's all. From soil, then to root hair, then epidermis of course will be here after root hair. Then our root hair is a part of epidermis, you can say, students, 100% root hair as extensions of epidermal cells also, you can understand. We need not mention in that regard also, okay. So soil, then root hair, then it moves to cortex region, and from cortex it goes to the endodermis, then pericycle, and then proto, and then last to the metaxylem. Okay, so what is proto and metaxylem also you should know here, since it is mentioned in the options. So what is protoxylem? Protoxylem is nothing but the earlier formed or the first formed xylem. Metaxylem is nothing but the later formed or after protoxylem, the xylem that is formed is called meta. I repeat, the first formed xylem is called proto. The later formed xylem is called as the metaxylem. They show different arrangements also, okay, where it is placed, whether towards the periphery or towards the fifth region. Based on that, we have different conditions, endarch, exarch, etc., etc. That is not related to this chapter, but still you should just recall the things, okay. So what I was telling, pathway of water would be option C, that is soil to root hair, cortex, endodermis, then proto, last one is the metaxylem. Option C is the answer. Okay. So question number 28, when concentration of solution is low in the soil, absorption of water is, okay. So, read the question carefully when you are listening to the class. When concentration of solution is low in the soil, means in the soil, concentration of solution is low, then absorption of water would stop, increase, retarded, normal. Okay. What do you mean by this concentration of solution is low? Means solutes are low in the soil. Try to understand what is low in the soil. Solutes are low in the soil. When solutes are low, means what is more? Water is more. Indirectly in the question he is telling, when concentration of water is more in the soil. I hope now you can understand indirectly what is the meaning of the question. When concentration of water is more in the soil, what happens to absorption of water by the roots? Whether it stops, whether it increases, whether it gets retarded, or whether it is normal. So definitely when there is more water in the soil, absorption definitely will increase. Option B, absorption will definitely increase, students. It will not be stopped. When it will be stopped, absorption, when there will be more and more root pressure, that means, and when there is transpiration is blocked, that time to an extent we can say it can retarded or stopped. Normal, when the normal transpiration and normal root pressure is there, pull is normal, it will be normalized. Environmental conditions play a role there. So here, 88, answer is option B, increase. Okay, we'll go to question number 89 now. So what is question number 89? Select the correct ones. Okay, select the correct ones. A dash, apoplastic movement of water occurs exclusively through cell wall. Options, statements are given. A, what is the statement? A, apoplastic movement of water occurs exclusively through the cell wall. Okay. So what do you understand about this statement? Is it a right or wrong statement? Yes, 100% it is a right statement, because apoplast occurs through cell wall. So A is right. Okay. Let us see B. Solutes increase free energy of water or water potential. The statement, solutes increase free energy of water, absolutely wrong. Okay. Rather, it should be solutes should decrease the free energy. Students, I hope you are understanding. Solutes do not increase the free energy of water. They lower the free energy of water and hence they retard or lower the water potential. An opposite thing is given in statement B. So, statement B is an incorrect statement. Statement C, simplest plastic movement occurs through the plasmodesmata. 100% statement is right. Then statement D, membrane permeability depends upon membrane composition as well as chemical nature of the solute. Yes, this statement is right because permeability depends on membrane composition. Membrane composition means what? Whether the membrane is having more of proteins or more of lipids. Okay. Because you know that membrane chemical nature will be generally same only. All biological membranes are made up of lipids and proteins. But only difference is the percentage of lipids and proteins differ, students. Okay. That is called composition. If you just see, for example, I can tell you here, mitochondria only if you see or chloroplast, they are double membranous organelles. Outer membrane composition is different and inner membrane composition is different. Okay. So, permeability depends on composition, right? As well as chemical nature of solute is also right. Which solute can pass? Definitely, it can differ. So, statement D is right. So, what you have to find out in the question, select the correct ones. A is right, C is right, D is right. Option C is the answer. Statement B is the wrong statement among all these. So, option C, I am repeating 89, option C. Now, question number 90, we will see. In order to demonstrate the root pressure, the plant is given a cut. Okay. So, a question is asked here about the root pressure. So, what is root pressure? Let us just rewind ourselves and go back. Root pressure is the pressure which develops in the xylem elements. It is a positive pressure, always remember, developing in the tracheary elements or xylem elements due to the passive absorption of water. I repeat, due to the passive absorption of water. Why this passive absorption occurs? Because root cells actively absorb some ions from the soil to balance that water diffuses and inside builds up a pressure. That pressure is called root pressure. The plant is given a cut. When you want to demonstrate the pressure, where you are cutting the plant? At the tip, transition zone, few centimeters above the soil and a few centimeters below the soil. At the tip would be totally wrong because root pressure is a weak pressure. It does not rise till the tip of the plant, student. It can rise or it shows its influence only up to certain height of the plant. Okay, not the complete height or not the full length of the plant. So, if you cut the plant at the tip, you will not be able to demonstrate root pressure. Okay, I hope I am clear. B option, if you see transition zone. So, what is this transition zone? Transition zone is the zone which is present underground in the root region. If you just recall, in the root region, there are different regions like region of meristem, region of maturation, elongation. There, the zone appears. It is not related to this question. A few centimeters above the soil, 100% would be the answer because I said root pressure will be influencing up to a certain height of the plant, not the entire length of the plant. So, a few centimeters above the soil, if you just cut the plant, if you give a cut to the plant, easily you can see water is oozing out of the xylem vessels and that is due to root pressure. So, option C is the answer for question 90. Option D, a few centimeters below the soil totally would be wrong here. So, option C is the answer. Okay. So, now we'll go to question number 91. Okay. So, question number 91. In root hair, water enters due to? Very simple question. Many times I have discussed this. Is it diffusion? Is it WP? What is WP, students? WP is not water potential. WP is wall pressure. WP is not water potential. Again and again, I tell this in the classes also. Many students get confused it to be as water potential. It is not water. It is wall pressure. Okay. So, diffusion, wall pressure, turgor pressure, osmotic pressure. So, question is why water enters the root here? How it enters? It due to what? What is the phenomenon? Absolutely, it is diffusion. Okay. It is diffusion. By means of diffusion, water enters. The option A is the answer. Now, question number 92. So recognize the figure and find out the correct matching. You have a diagram here, okay? So where labelings you have to find out, A, B, C, D, E, F labelings you have to just locate here. So if we will just see here what is this A, okay? So A, if you just see carefully, A, the movement is shown like this, where the water is entering through the cytoplasm. If you just see carefully on the screen as well, if you can refer your Cengage book also, students, the water is passing through the protoplasm. So definitely what is A, students? A is symplast. Okay. Now let us come to B. Okay. Now what is B? B, if you just see, water is passing through the adjacent cells. Look at the direction of movement. Water is passing through the adjacent cell through the wall spaces only. Okay, it is not entering the cytoplasm. So what would be B? B is 100% apoplast. Okay, so A is symplast, B is apoplast. Now what is this? E, this is E. Okay, C is the second C is here. Yeah, this is C. So what is C? If you just see carefully, C is the endodermal layer which is showing suberin and lignin deposition. C is the endodermal layer. Okay. Then D, if you see carefully, for D, there is a labeling given here. D labeling is nothing but the Casparian strip here. D is the Casparian strip, okay? E is the cortex region. And F is the innermost, which is in contact with the vascular bundle. That is the pericycle layer. So with this, we have to look at the options carefully. So after deciding all these things in the labelings, you should conclude that, I repeat, A is symplast, B is apoplast, C is endodermis, D is strip, E is cortex, F is pericycle. Option B is the answer. Okay. So it's a direct question. Just you have to see and answer it properly. I repeat, option B. Okay. I'll come to the question number 93 here. Okay. Question number 93. Water potential in leaf tissue is positive. That means near zero during. Okay. Water potential is positive near during. Option number A, low transpiration, excessive absorption, excessive transpiration, guttation. Water potential in leaf tissue. Leaf tissue, we are talking about the only leaf part here, okay? And it is having a positive value or near to zero, you can say, okay? During what? Low transpiration. When the transpiration is low, water potential will be negative. Excessive absorption. If excessive absorption occurs in the root region, so here you cannot directly correlate to leaf tissue, okay? Then excessive transpiration, when there is excessive transpiration, then negative value will develop. Then option number D, guttation, is the right answer here. So what is guttation, students? Guttation is a phenomenon in which water is lost from the margins or the edges of the leaf, okay, in the form of liquid droplets. So there are many differences between guttation and transpiration. I would like to just highlight here. You can listen carefully. Guttation is also loss of water. Transpiration is also loss of water. Guttation, water is lost in the form of droplets. Transpiration, water is lost in the form of vapors. Transpiration, water lost is pure water, students. Whereas guttation, the water that is lost is not pure. It is having some dissolved salts and other components in it. It is not a pure water that is lost. Okay. And transpiration is found in all plants. Guttation may not be reported in all plants. And guttation actually occurs when there is excess absorption and there is a positive potential develops. Okay, that is also one reason. So for question number 93, guttation is the absolute answer here. You cannot correlate directly to transpiration. Option number D is the answer. Question number 24, let us see now. Water in plants is transported by, or ascent of sap takes place through. Okay. Ascent of sap. Now, what is the meaning of this ascent of sap? Transpiration pull Transpiration pull is also explained by means of ascent of sap. Sap means what? Sap means a solution which is having dissolved solutes in it, okay, and salts, etc. Ascent means it is moving in an upward direction against the gravitational force, okay. So transpiration theory is also called as cohesion adhesion, or it's also referred to as ascent of sap. It takes place through cambium, it takes place through phloem, through xylem and through epidermis. So definitely when I am talking about transpiration, then I should definitely refer to xylem. Cambium is nowhere responsible. What is cambium actually? What is cambium? Cambium is that tissue which is responsible for secondary growth in dicots. I repeat, in the anatomy chapter you have come across this word cambium. Cambium is nothing but a strip of meristem actually. How do you define cambium, students? It's a strip of meristem which is present between the xylem and phloem, and it is responsible for one major function, that is nothing but it giving rise to secondary growth in plants. Nowhere related to this question. Phloem is not the answer for ascent of sap. Xylem is 100% because tracheary elements are those which are responsible for upward movement. Epidermis is not the answer. Option C, question number 94. Now, question number 95, if you see, water entering root due to diffusion is a part of, okay. Water, when it enters the root system due to diffusion, we already have discussed this, okay. It's a part of endocytosis, imbibition, passive absorption, active absorption. So, with our previous understanding, easily you should answer this question. It is not endocytosis, it is not imbibition, it is definitely passive absorption. So, what passive absorption it is? Nothing but diffusion. Because diffusion is a type of passive absorption. You tell either diffusion or passive absorption, both are same. Active is totally wrong. Active is applicable for ions and other substances, not for water. For water, mainly passive absorption. Endocytosis also I would like to tell here. It is the uptake of substances by the cell through the plasma membrane. That is intake, okay? Intake from the surrounding. That's called endocytosis. Imbibition, absorption of water by the solid colloidal particles. Options C, passive absorption. Water will be absorbed by the root hairs when the external medium is, okay. Water, when it is absorbed by the root hairs, okay. When the external medium is hypotonic or hypertonic or isotonic or viscous, okay. So here, when water will be absorbed, definitely when the external medium is hypotonic, okay. Hypo means less of solute should be there, more of water should be there. In the previous question, a few questions back itself, I said that when water is more in the soil particle, then easy absorption occurs. Hypertonic, if it is hypertonic, water cannot be taken inside. Isotonic also, because in isotonic, there is a two-way movement, entry as well as exit, it cannot be applicable. Viscous is not the answer here. Viscosity definitely will control, but it is not the answer. Option number A, hypotonic, is the right option. Now, question number 97, we'll see. The principal pathway of water translocation in angiosperms is, okay. We are talking about flowering plants, angiosperms. What is the major pathway of water translocation? Is it seed cells? Is it sieve tube elements? Is it xylem vessel elements? And it is it xylem and phloem? Okay. So the answer for this is water translocation mainly occurs through the xylem vessel elements, because in the question, angiosperms is asked, because you should know that in angiosperms, vessels are the main conducting elements, okay? Because in gymnosperms, vessels are absent. In gymnosperms, if you just recall, vessels are absent. So definitely in angiosperms, it is the vessels which do this function. Option C is the right answer. Now I'll come to the last question here. That is, guttation is mainly due to root pressure. Is it due to osmosis? Is it due to transpiration or due to imbibition? Guttation I've already explained. Again, I will not repeat the same thing. You already know that. Guttation is mainly due to what? It is mainly due to root pressure. Excess of root pressure will give rise to oozing or loss of water through the leaf margins. Not osmosis, not the other option. So 98, option number A is the right answer. Okay. So in today's class, I have discussed one subtopic, that is the long distance transport of water in plants. In the next session, I'll be coming to the next subtopic, that is transpiration, uptake and transport of the mineral nutrients. And next class will be the last session for this chapter, because already I have discussed many sessions on this chapter, transport in plants. One more class I will take on this chapter, and then I'll be concluding this chapter, students. Okay. Thank you.